Hello everybody, welcome back to Back Out of the Case. This is Skyflight 44, aka Zect 44. And today I'm going to continue playing some more Final Fantasy 12. Now, I did do one thing in the license board before. Actually, you can see it right now. I got channeling, which brings down my MP cost by 10%. There's three of those in the entire license board. And to be honest, you're going to be wanting to get them right about now. Cura is the spell that... That doesn't make it required, but is when it's going to be needed. Very, very much needed. And already, went from 32 MP to just 28. So I can actually cast it a couple of times instead of just twice, like three times. Let's at least kill off all these dudes first. I don't want them stealing my kill. And plus, that thing's already going to be protected. This is the Uratan Eater. It's not all that difficult, but as you can see, especially considering it's protected... Ooh, turtle shell. I can sell it for a lot. The Rutan Yensa cannot actually beat this thing. This thing specifically eats them and them alone. So, if we kill this thing, we go back, we continue with that little side plot. What was he even trying to do? Oh well, some technique I probably never do. And like most fucking annoying creatures, once you get its health low enough, it does so little actual damage to it. Like 25% damage I would generally be doing. But that is 8 LP. I'll see you back there. Okay. Now that we've gone and killed that thing, we can talk to the Mooga. Yep, I am amazing. Oh, maybe he was going to look for that treasure for you. Unusually kind of him, of course. Thing about it is, all we need to go and do to continue on with this is to go up to that, basically a not really attempt to leave, but just get up high enough on this thing, and we'll see it running back there. And this is something I do recommend doing. Yep, it's running back. Hey, look, it's that Moogle. And again, there is a reward to this. And I don't know if you can actually do this after this point. Really don't remember if you can actually do this or not. But it's just interesting. And the interesting part is this right here. As the actual screen comes in, we see that there's all this Uratan Yensa around. With probably the queen, you know, slash probably like a matriarch or something in the middle. I believe specifically a female, if I remember. Yeah, the Mughal thinks it's a rare occurrence for them to come together to actually see something like this. They're communicating. I guess the Mughal might know more than we do. Yeah, they're gonna execute him. Mughal, you don't understand. Yeah, the creature would still be at large if it weren't for his plea for help. Shame us by seeking aid from outside the tribe. Rutan Yen said, "Lords and masters of the Great Sea, we seek the aid of none." Words are howling the sand to my ears. I condemn you to dust. Now the Mughal's sad. Those who sully our name will be punished, be they foemen or kin. They must pay the honor price. There can be no forgiveness. I would destroy you too, but I am merciful. Better you live to tell the truth, to tell the world that the Rutan are not to be taken lightly. Now leave. That's pretty. In the scope of the entire game, this is pointless. This entire thing is pointless. But it's interesting. And what is left for us is a flower. Something we can use against the boss that's going to be coming up. Yeah, it's a rare one blooming in the sand sea. Let's go pick it. Pick the berries. Eskier berries will help us fight the next boss. You use it, and it does quite a bit of damage to it. I guess it doesn't like them at all. But I'm not gonna steal anymore. I'm just gonna fight and then continue on. But the entire native aspect to it, what I'm trying to get at, is it's a little mysterious tribe that we don't really get a full understanding of. But from the glimpses of what we see, the Rutan Yensa actually probably have quite a little complex society. And again, none of this comes back again in the story. Nothing about it comes back into the story. And we really don't learn anything else about these dudes. Unless it's in the bestiary, which, if I look at, I probably already have the thing done. Yep. There's 6 actual pages here. Maybe talking about it. I definitely know that this one. Yep. Race evolved from crustaceans to bipedal humanoids. The hides are extremely hard, covered with stiff bristles and needle-like hair. Interesting. Ooh, a teleport stone! I always love getting teleport stones. Oh yeah, by the way, tri-attack hurts. That's like the one attack that's really kind of powerful from him. Again? If you have Cura... Oh, another teleport stone. Holy shit. Granted, I should be able to start buying them once I take out the Wyvern Lord. But... seriously. Holy crap. I'm getting a lot of teleport stones. Oh shit, that's right. I did not take into account the Wyvern Lord. I probably... maybe I should have shown this entire, the rest of the, Rutan Yensa, a little side questy thing. Just so that I could, some of these, most of these parts being super long, but seriously. I would really, really rather have. I don't even remember what I'm saying. That fucking Wyvern Lord's gonna take a while to kill. I'm just gonna throw that out there. Kill it while you have Vossler. Kill that motherfucker while you have Vossler. You have to use your long-ranged weapons or magic. Last time, I beat it with magic. I'm not doing that shit again. I am not gonna do that shit again. Really, should I go this way? There's, again, as you can probably guess, two ways to cross the, there's two ways to cross the Nam, if I remember. Probably gonna wanna go the other way, because this is just going to repeat, visually, more so anyway, is going to repeat visually what the Ogier Yensa was like. I like going this way just because, well, there are these little docks that the Rosarians built all of these, which I failed to mention that earlier, but oh well. Get to attacking. Didn't hurt too hard. But actually, I might have said this earlier, but Rosaria basically has been fighting, or is very not antagonistic, but there's a lot of animosity between Rosaria and the Arcadian Empire. Rosaria and the Arcadian Empires are not friends. And the big people suffering from them, like Bosch has pointed out, were all these small nations in the middle. Landis, which Bosch and Gabrant. Oh, interesting. Which Bosch and Gabrant actually originated from. Bosch fleeing to Dalmasca. Which actually, I don't even think is the closest area to. Well, definitely not closest. It wasn't the closest region to the Arcadian Empire, anyway. That would have been Nebradia, but. There was also, I've said Nebradia, and as well, Dalmasca, all in the middle. Between Rosaria and Arcades. Well, that's capital, but the Arcadian Empire. And any war between the two is just the central area, the small little kingdoms and city-states between the two are going to be the ground, the battleground. And that's the big plot here. And what the entire resistance thing is going to boil down to. Why the resistance really can't fight. They really can't fight the Arcadian Empire. There's no way in hell they're going to be able to fight the Arcadian Empire. However, this will be a perfect time for, let's say, Rosaria or Arcadia to just basically take interest a bit more than they should and use it as further grounds for attacking the other. Like, maybe let's say Rosaria wants to go and back the Dalmascan resistance, or the insurgents at this point. They've long been... It's been long... been insurgents, really. If it's been 2 years... in which they've been occupied... it's insurgents. Yeah. One of the things we're going to be needing is a Curaga. Curaga is actually a single target spell, and we're going to be getting it soonish. Possibly after we do the Wraithwall, Tomb of Wraithwall bit. The big thing about Curaga is that it costs less, and it heals for a lot more on single target, pretty much. At this point, it will probably be close to 900 to 1,000. It's absolutely amazing when it comes to that. And you're probably going to be using it too. Like, one of the gambits I usually set on both Pinello and Ash is a Cure Gambit. In which, less than 30%, they'll go and cast Curaga on a character. Because, oh, Rainbow Egg, cool. Wasn't expecting that. It was actually pretty rare. But, damn. Oh, yeah, the Curaga Gambit. It doesn't have too much MP cost when compared to something like Cura. And it's also far more useful in the, a bent staff's actually really cool. I'm definitely gonna be liking that. Away. Yeah, that's gonna be... I'll show this off. But we're not going in here. I knew I was going the wrong way. This is those caverns I was talking about. That you can get into. There's also a place in Dalmaskan, West of Sand, and the Giza... Not the Giza Plains. Something just a bit farther than the Giza Plains. I forgot what it was called. Yeah, let's just kill the spear tongues and get the hell out of here. You can actually fight these guys, these spear tongues, inside the Nam Yensa. Oh, Angel Song, I do not want that on you. Oh, and you also have regen. Oh well. The enemies in here quickly turn to basically level 40s. So, we're not going to want to be in here. Skin of Frog Oil. I've never seen that before. I wonder what it actually... how much it sells for. If I can get anything for it in the bazaar. Oh well. But that's a completely optional area you never have to go to. And again, a lot of these little areas in the game... like, that one's completely optional. The, one of the highlands next to... What was that city called? Was it next to the, Tichita Uplands or something? Interesting enough. Okay, this is where I have to go. Probably... yeah, I was probably, want to kill all those fucking bird things. Because, again, those bent staves, or those bent staves, I mean. Very, very good for selling. You can get a couple hundred for those. No, gold needle. Oh, there's something over there, too. And Pinello seems to have leveled up again. Oh, well. I'm not going to be doing any more level grinding. Or really any kind of grinding for quite a while. Not at least until we get to Mount Brahmises. Because we can actually get something we're going to want right there. Yeah. Well, that was a lot of sirens out there. Didn't want that to get recorded. I hate living on a busy road. Oh, well. We're actually getting close to the... Oh, damn, what was it called? We're actually getting close to the, place where you have to kill the Wyvern Lord. I don't necessarily fear that. As much as... Oh, I don't want to necessarily have to go through all that. I'm just remembering when I took that thing down with magic. That was so fucking annoying. Just because you don't have a lot of magic. And I think... No, I wasn't getting it enough quickening just yet. Once I actually get all my health arguments... And possibly my channeling items. I might not, just because... Oh well, we don't really need it. But... I'm going to be going after the... Well, definitely once we hit Mount Brahmises. And we get those double LP... accessories. That's when I'm going to start doing a lot of shit. And basically... if you actually have them on and you're not even using the characters, it still works. So, if you actually want to go and the characters you're not using at the moment, you should probably put something like that on them. I mean, they are still getting license points. It's just they're not getting any experience. And this is also another area in which I would say go and use Libra or Libra. There's a lot of shit around here that you could just step on. Or at least in one area, I definitely remember there being a lot. Vega! Holy shit! I got another fucking, weapon. Another gun. And as you can see, I don't really want to go and get any license points for it. Very expensive. But once we get... I think I might have said this earlier, but... Once we get those quickenings up, we're actually going to be getting more and more bars of magic. Which, as you would expect... is going to allow us to get so much actual magic. Instead of just having like around, what, 50 magic points, well, 50 MP right now with Bosch, it's going to increase into, with all of them, 165 right now. Then, instead of just getting every level up, instead of getting like just 2 or 3 MP, I'm gonna be getting 6 or 9. So much better. Getting that, right there. Tons of fucking traps. But oh well, can't wait until we get those quickenings. Now this was where the other area leads into. I might explore it on my own later. I don't really need to show it. What we're here for is down this way. Well, I don't necessarily want to allow my beta party to lose any magic or health until I get there. Stupid bag of lace. I really hate these sons of bitches. I hate this entire breed of enemy, this entire class. They have a lot of health. Oh, another teleport stone. Maybe I don't hate them as much as I thought I did. What's with these fucking teleport stones coming out? I mean, that... Well, I don't understand. Is it a Navian? doesn't fly. Which, if I remember, these things are supposed to be something that people basically bred to become something like a war machine. Like a war machine, anyway. It's definitely no fucking machine. I want to make sure that they're all dead, too. But the fact that they can actually protect themselves, you shall. Goddamn annoying. Their health. Holy shit. Okay, we just had to kill these guys. So many of them. I didn't want to have to get too close just yet. Okay, you do Kiara. Oh, another bent staff. Absolutely love that. I thought there was more guys over here. Oh well, an ether. Well, see if Ranash can all come out. Don't get too close. Oh, damn it. Protect. We'll get all protects on. And right there is our enemy. Okay, you can use Protect on Bossler. Don't let Ash waste any more of her MP. Now you can. Oh shit! No, don't attack. Damn! Holy crap! That does a lot of damage. Oh crap, what is he doing now? I really like it when he actually attacks the party leader, because then I can go and get him wherever I want. But another reason why I like going and using a party like this, because they just spread out. And it's glorious when they spread out like this, because Arrow's not going to do, he's just going to be doing a little bit of damage. Oh, well, I'll just go right after Vossler. Yeah, he's hurt. Now, if I didn't have this Protect on, he would be doing over 100 with every single pop. And again, try and do this with magic. And with only water, it's our strongest one. This wasn't easy. Well, this definitely wasn't easy fight. Don't know if he has any straight out weaknesses though. That's one thing I don't know. However, the next fight we're going to be doing is also another fight with an avian. So I'm not going to be going and, well, changing up my party just yet. Those color bows, though, are definitely good. I'm sure you get different kind of arrows, though. There are fiery arrows. There's one that will deal poison damage. A couple of other ones. I really never went after too many of them. I don't even know how to get a lot of them. I might find that out. Probably out of game packs or something. But I only remember the guns generally. Well, the ammunition for it. I damn well though. like getting a good silent shot. Silent shot, really wonderful when it comes to just dealing with anything. And it's the fact that we really don't get anything for it. Actually, dark shot's pretty good too. Though it does do dark damage, but it's a good way of doing dark damage. And another bent staff. Awesome. But, actually going in, what was I talking about? Yeah, dark shot. Dark shot does, like, gives you quite a good amount of attack power, like maybe 4. And it does blind. It will blind your enemy for you. Not too frequently, but frequent enough. Absolutely wonderful. Now, let's see. Up this way, and we should see those same people that we've seen before. You know, those traitors. Ship right there. Now, if we actually go and beat the next boss, go out of the tomb, these guys will actually be in there. Yeah, the avian there is said to be invincible, but it has a weakness. I'm sure the Urtan Jensen know something. The Sansi's there, you see. Can't just go giving people fool advice like that. Yeah, they're not going to tell me. But oh well, I did get something. Okay, Cypress Pult. Earth elemental damage?
Interesting. But I am going to get rid of it. I've never actually used a pull like that. I really have never used a pull like that. Okay. Earth stones. Got a couple. Suckling fruit. Turtle shell. Oh, that's great. Large feathers and small feathers don't sell for much. Rainbow egg's pretty good, but as I said, frog oil, 2,000? Pretty much? Holy shit, those bent staves, or bent staves, really good. Okay, high potion pack, I wouldn't mind getting that. First aid kit, don't really need potions anymore. They're not going to be useful, especially considering the fact that I can get some pretty good stuff. Okay, we're definitely going to... Don't really... Thinking about buying some of those, but... They sell Capella and Killer Bows here. Mainly just because they're telling you there's a fight up ahead, in which you're going to need that. Gonna also have to get Protect on everybody. Once again, I'm gonna... I probably should get one on Vassar as well. Which I'm probably going to do with Fran. Actually, I'm gonna use that with Balthier. Just because Balthier isn't really all that good when it comes to magic power to begin with. And therefore, even Fran's MP's worth more. Not to mention, I walk around quite a lot more than the AI does. Yeah, we have a chance to save the game. I wonder why. Because we've gone so far, and... This would be a dick move. Because the first time I actually fought this guy, I wasn't doing too well. And this, the Tomb of Wraithwell was a huge wake-up call to me. And from now... Oh, well. Oh, cool, look at that. We all healed up. Cool. It's like that was a temporary save crystal there or something. And now for Garuda. Go and use the Eskier berries. Yep, Garuda doesn't like this. And from what I remember, that should weaken him. Considering how much damage we're doing, I really do think that that weakened him quite a bit. And now this guy's not going to even be a challenge. First time I did this, did not have the Eskier berries. It was far harder. Bye-bye.
Long ago, the gods granted their favor to King Wraithwall, who would oversee the subjugation of a vast territory spanning from Mordalia to Valendia. Here he forged the Galtean Alliance. Though he is called the Dynast King, upon establishing the Alliance, he demonstrated compassion for his people and disdain for needless war. A philosophy passed on to his successors, one that would bring peace and prosperity for hundreds of years to follow. It was during this time of peace that the city-states of Arcadia and Rosaria, each members of Wraithwall's alliance, took root and flourished. Wraithwall left three relics signifying descent from the Dynast King. Of these, the Midlight Shard was given to what would become House Nebradia, and the Dusk Shard to my ancestors, the founders of Dalmasca. The last of these relics was the Dawn Shard. It remained hidden here, known only to those of royal blood.
As though the Dynast King foresaw the very plight before us now.
None save descendants of the King are suffered within. If we attempt to enter without proof of such lineage...
There's no guarantee we'll make it out alive. Vicious beasts, fiendish traps, something like that?
Mm-hmm. But you must consider the prize. The Dawn Shard lies within, and Wraithwall's treasure.
And there was I, thinking this was going to be hard.
Yeah. I definitely view this next part as being... The game in general... For the main part of the game, if you don't actually go and do any kind of level grinding, the game's going to get hard on you. If you don't know how to utilize the, if you don't know how to utilize the, what was it called? Blazer gloves, what is this? Oh, that's what I bought. I think I bought it for more expensive than I could have just got it here. Fuck's sake. Oh! Interesting. Let's buy at least 5 of those. I would very much like to get Berserk.
Not necessarily for now, but for when I actually have another item. Not to mention, items work pretty much really, really well. So if you are having trouble berserking an enemy, go and use one of these on them and it should berserk them. Which is good.
Oh, well. Let's see. I'm Vanguard now, so I should be able to buy teleport stones. Oh, well. How much license points do I have? Aw, oh, shitload. Oh, well. I'm going to have to be spending that next part. Let's go and get everybody suited up with their regular. Shit. Well, you keep that. And you're going to be using a cherry staff. I am going to be using these three inside the place itself, but not for the boss. There's one more boss I need to defeat before I end it here. Yes, let's touch the device. This is actually an interesting boss, and one which I think you're supposed to go and face them. But it's two bosses. I don't know. Okay. Now, I don't even think you can beat this boss easily when the first time you go in here. But to actually beating the boss will bring these actual will actually bring up these stairs. Well, maybe it's just like a ramp or something. I don't really remember. But this is actually a pretty ingenious boss. Let's get Protect up. If you actually look at it from here, you won't see anything, and you'll go and do exactly what I just did.
Fight or run? We better decide fast.
This is the demon wall. If you actually go and I believe maybe you can't do it in this one. But if you can't actually... Oh, shit. Echo herbs. You might be able to defeat this thing. It has reflect and haste. Well, haste on it. You'd want to get rid of that haste immediately. However, let's run. I'm gonna try and get Echo Herbs on Pinello immediately. And then let's get the hell out of here. And this is one of my favorite moments of Final Fantasy XII. You run away from a demon wall, which you don't see coming. Or you most likely won't see coming. And then what do you run into? Another boss! Let's face yet another demon wall.
The wall comes, we must be quick. Together we can get it done.
Okay, this demon wall can actually be beaten in a far longer period of time. And you can also touch these. Read the inscription. These words have been left by the tomb watchers. Wakes it with their flames. Follow it their shadow. Nair's straying. Oh well. Basically, you can either speed this thing up or slow its advancement by getting something good down there. I'm gonna kill the demon wall though.
Now, you can kill both of them. Oh, shit. No, no, don't attack. Okay. Yeah, everybody. Fucking hell. Damn it. And then you can get a... Where is it? Eye drops on Vossler. But you can beat both of these demon walls, but that second one over there is definitely... Well, the first one is not something you're going to be able to beat easily. It is not something you're going to be able to beat. Oh, shit. X-Zone. Until I kill this thing, Vaughn's gone. Vaughn, kill it. Yes. Once again, this screen. Though, at this point, Vaughn should be back. I killed the damn thing. Hopefully he still gets the license points from beating that thing, which I'm gonna have a fun time spending all the license points I have stuck that I haven't used. But just think, if I had the other thing, I would be able golden armlet, something like that. Oh well. Is there a... Okay, probably not a, it's probably not anything I can get. But, fuck, I can't go that way. Fucking demon wall. I have to go this way, and there should be something that'll allow me to teleport out so that I can actually at least, you know, get Vaughn out of his X-Zone state. Because that's pretty annoying.
Incredible. It wounds me to look on as they pillage so solemn a place.
Yet without help, you and I are as nothing. Is this not so? He thinks ever and always on his own profit. Assure him of it and he shall remain true to our cause.
I do not share your Majesty's trust.
We will continue this later. Now we should concern ourselves with finding the Dawn Shard. It sleeps in waiting, somewhere deep within.
How can you be certain?
I can hear its call.
Oh, Vaughn's back. Oh well. Remember those words she just said? She hears it calling. But oh well, this is it for now. See you in the next part, everybody. Until next time.